Hey everyone, in this video I will be showing you how to use OpenAI API with Python. So let's get started. So the prerequisite for this video is you must have Python installed on your system. If you don't have, you can just click on the card that is appearing on top. I've done an entire video on that. So now first thing, we must have an OpenAI account. Just Google OpenAI, you will be having the official link from openai.com. Just open it, and you can also use your ChatGPT account to sign in. And to the top, you'll be having the login option. We are interested in their API platform. So just select this. And I have already signed in, so you must also make sure that you are signing in. And next thing is, you must have credits to use this OpenAI API. It is not free, it is paid. For example, to the top, you'll be having your profile, right? Select it and you'll be having your profile. Click that. And here you'll be having an option called as billing. Select it. And here you need to add credits. So only after adding credits, you'll be able to use OpenAI API key. So once you're good here, let's just go and start our coding. So for this, we'll be requiring two packages. One is OpenAI and another one is python.env, because we are going to store our OpenAI API key in an .env file. So it's a good practice to do that. So just copy this and run in your terminal. So that's it, I've already installed. So for me, it's showing requirement already satisfied. So after this is done, again, go to OpenAI's official website. Here at the top, you'll be having this docs option. Open it in a new tab. And here we'll be having the overview, quick start, models, pricing, etc. We can just go to quick start. And if you scroll down, as you can see here, we can set it as an environment variable and make your first API request. Just go here to Python, and we have done this pip install OpenAI. And this is the code that we are going to use. So we can just literally copy this code and make use of it. So just copy this and paste it over here. That's it. We have done most of our work. And now we need to add our OpenAI API key. So as I told you earlier, we will be using a .env file. So click on a new file and name it as .env. And inside this file, it's going to be in capital letters, OpenAI underscore API underscore key equal to. And now again, go to OpenAI's official website. And this time you need to go to your profile and you'll be having the API keys option over here. Select this. And here just select create new secret key. And you can just have a name. Let me go with demo. And next one is the project. I will just go with default project. And if you want, you can change the permissions. This is up to you. I'll just go with all and create secret key. So once the key is created, just copy this and make sure that you are not sharing this key to anyone. In case if you feel your key has been compromised, you can immediately delete this. Okay, because if you share the key, they can use it in their own project and your credits will be burned at the end. So don't do that, and just paste the key here. Okay, you don't have to put this within double quotes. Just paste it and save. That's it. We are good over here. Now we need to load the key from our .env file into our .py file. So for that only we are having the .env library. So it's going to be from .env, and I'm having it automatically. It's going to be import load underscore .env. And the next line, it's going to be load .env. Okay, this is going to be the code. And we also need OS. So you can go to the top and you can just have it as import OS. And basically you can just, you know, cut this client thing and just cut it, and you can just have it here. And after this, we need to pass our API key inside our OpenAI's object. So just go here. It's going to be API underscore key equals OS dot get env, and within that we need to pass this particular name that we're having over here. So just going to copy this and put it over here. So this will basically get the value of OpenAI API key and put it over here. So in case if you're having multiple secret keys, you can just keep on adding it here. So now we are good. Let me quickly explain the code, and we are having the chat completion, and this is the place where we will give our user prompt. So in ChatGPT, give a input prompt, right? This is quite similar to that. And here we are specifying the model. So in my case, I'm going with GPT-40 mini, and this is the response. We are storing the response in completion, and then we are just displaying the message over here. So now let's see what we are getting in the output. And let me just go with a small prompt, like give me a 10 line essay on AI, or poem. Let me go with a poem, that would be better. 10 line poem on AI, that's it. So for running this, just come to terminal, and it's going to be Python space your file name. In my case, it's OpenAI API dot py. You need to run it with the extension. So as you can see here, it has returned us an object, and inside content I am having the poem, and we are also having some metadata. So what if you wanted to only get the poem alone, you don't want this extra metadata and stuff? In that case, you can directly access this content thing. So just go here, rather than printing the message directly, you can just destructure it more till content. Okay, so it needs to be inside this. So come inside here dot content, that's it. So now if we rerun again, this time I'm literally getting that poem itself. I'm not getting this object thing with this new lines and stuff, and it has beautifully given us in 10 lines 4 here and 2. So this is amazing. Next thing is, what if you wanted to have a control on the number of output tokens that get generated? Because in some cases the API is going to give a lot of response. In my case, I'm restricting it by giving it 10 line poem. So what if you wanted to like have a restriction or set a max number of output tokens? In that case, what you can do is you can just add here a particular parameter which is called as max tokens. So this basically determines the number of output words that get generated. For example, in this case, for the demo purpose, let me just go with 20 tokens. So now, even though I'm giving 10 line poem, it will obey this max token. So I'll be not getting 10 lines now, but very less than that. So let's see how many lines I get now. I'm just going to run this. So as you can see, I literally got 3 lines. So this is because I've given the max tokens as 20. So by this way, you can also, you know, control the number of output tokens that you get. And in case if you want to change the model, you can just go to like models or pricing, and this is going to be the model name because they're having the GPT-40 mini, right? So we can literally give GPT-40. So I can just go here and just remove this. Yeah, so this is going to now send this input to GPT-40, and if I run it, I'll be getting this exact same 2-line response because we are having the restriction as 20 tokens. So this is just a beginning. So, and in case if you want to dive deeper, they have a whole ocean available over here. We are having text generation, vision, image, audio. We're having embeddings, structured outputs, fine tunings, and we're also having the real-time voice thing. So you can literally like play around with this in their documentation. So yeah, they have this much of stuff available over here. So I guess that's the video, guys. Do check the playlist of my channel. I've done a lot of tutorials in AI, as well as AI APIs, Gemini AI, OpenAI API, also programming in general. Check the playlist, subscribe me. Thanks for watching.